less than a lap of fuel now. The tank is empty. That's Kimi ahead. Their best lap time is a 1 minute 42.9.
We're in Belgium once again for today's round of the Formula One World Championship. It's a race the great Ayrton Senna won 6 times, and in 2019, Charles Leclerc became the first driver to take their maiden win here since Michael Schumacher in 1992. Spa-Francorchamps today, a circuit that spans 4.35 miles. There are tons of elevation changes along the way too. 19 corners making up this circuit, with 9 of those to the right and the remaining 10 to the left. This track is a great one for fans of pure speed. The average lap speed comes close to a whopping 145 miles an hour. Anthony Davidson is alongside me as usual for the race today. Let's talk about more. They've been involved in a number of costly incidents lately. That's got to affect their mindset going into this race.
Certainly confidence is an important factor. And every time you're involved in an incident, it's not just the car you damage, but that confidence as well. But all the top racing drivers are able to tune that out when the race gets underway and focus on the job at hand.
Before we begin, let's take a quick look at the grid lineup for today's race. Good job yesterday from Valtteri Bottas. The Finn starts from pole position, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Albon, Sergio Perez, and Vettel, Leclerc, Sainz, Norris, and Daniel Kvyat, Gasly, Stroll, Daniel Ricciardo, and Ocon, Grosjean, Moore, Kimi Raikkonen, and Kevin Magnussen, Russell, and Nicholas Latifi. Now, it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track.
Let's capitalize on that first lap. clear. A teammate behind is 3.9 seconds. Receive you at the end of this lap. front is 3.6 seconds. Two laps of fuel remaining. Okay, gap ahead is 8.2 seconds. The car in front is 12.8 seconds. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
What a great race then, and what a magnificent victory here at the Belgium Grand Prix. Talk to me, Ant. What was it that set them apart from the competition today?
Well, this was a real team victory. They put together a solid strategy today that appeared well suited to the conditions out on track. The driver did everything that was expected of them in the moment to really execute the team's plan to perfection. A shining example of how F1 really is a team sport.
After an excellent performance at the Grand Prix, I'm sure there'll be plenty of celebrations tonight amongst the Mercedes team. And they certainly deserve it. Standings. It's a great result for Lewis Hamilton, who moves further ahead at the top of the table. Now, let's discuss, Ant. Who would you say is a contender for driver of the day?
I have to give it to Moore. They did a great job at getting the most out of their tyres without losing pace, something that's a very handy skill to have in modern-day Formula One.
Let's move on to the constructors. Mercedes continue to extend their lead. Meanwhile, a strong weekend from...
great workout there today. Let's have your thoughts. You were cutting your way through the field during the race. Do you think you were lucky not to end your race with that crash?
Thank you.